As Hi-5 soldiered on, their next single, titled Quality Time, began climbing the charts, written and produced by an up-and-coming talent named R. Kelly.
Working with R. Kelly was really them trying to show this mature side. It's important because they were now getting closer to 20, so it couldn't be as cutesy as something like Kissing Game or a lot of the earlier singles, so it had to have a little bit more of a mature sound.
And man, you know, R. Kelly has that ghetto, smooth R&B flow, kind of like that gospel edge. Man, I don't know what R. Kelly has, but he has it. From now on,
Quality Time reached number 3 on the R&B charts and helped give Hi-5 their second gold album.
Hearing Tony do R. Kelly riffs and sing like R. Kelly, you know, it's entertaining, man, because the kid sounds amazing.
Girl, you have got me in a messed up state of mind, and I don't know what to do, baby, tell me.
While touring behind Quality Time, Hi-5 was also recording their third album, and they were taking offers from other labels to sign with after their 3-album deal with Jive ran out.
The contract was coming to an end, and we just wanted to weigh our options. So I know that, you know, it probably was a difficult process for the record company because they weren't sure if we were going to stay with them or what we were doing.
We ended up with Giant Records, and there was a signing bonus put forth, and we each got a certain amount of money. It was like $60,000 a piece.
But then, Neil says, the other members decided to cut his share of the bonus.
And they said, Russ, you remember when you refused to come with us to Miami? And I'm like, yeah. Well, we're going to fine you for that. You're only going to get 30. And the other 30, we're going to split it. I looked them in the eye. I said, man, not only can you have that 30 grand, you can have this group.
With Russell Neil gone for good, Hi-5 recruited 2 new members, Shannon Gill and Terrence Murphy.
At first, I was kind of nervous, you know, being the replacement of somebody and not knowing the circumstances of why, you know, this person didn't want to come back on the board. But eventually, I got past it.
Kenlock told me when he first came and got me, he was like, I mean, I know you can sing, Shannon, and this album is pretty much almost done. He's like, but the next album, you know, you're going to be singing. I was like, that's cool.
Murphy and Gill appeared on the cover of Hi-5's final album for Jive, Faithful, as well as the video for its breakout single, Never Should Have Let You Go.
Compared to some of their other music, Hi-5 went into something of a slow jam in this regard, and it was right on time for a group that was going through major changes. They were becoming from boys to men.
It was kind of like what we were going through personally too as well, because, you know, we loved each other as people and individuals, and We were going through changes, so you had to have a certain respect for each other just to keep continuing.
No, I never should have let you go.
Never Should Have Let You Go became Hi-5's 6th top 10 hit. But after 2 gold-selling albums, Faithful failed to reach the top 20, and with the group poised to leave Jive Records, the label had little motive to do more.
Jive did what they were supposed to do, but they did not spend an overwhelming amount of money. You wouldn't imagine them in doing that.
Although it was a great album, the fact is, without promotion, there's no such thing as a good album. And there wasn't a lot of promotion with this album at all.
We made a decision to, you know, to go to another record label, and that probably, you know, looking in retro, that wasn't the best decision for us.
We'll be right back. On July 2, 2014, former High Five member Russell Neal entered a county sheriff's office in Houston, Texas, and told authorities that his wife, 24-year-old Catherine Martinez, was dead at their home. Police found that Neal's wife, who was also the mother of their two young children, had been stabbed multiple times. Russell Neal was arrested and charged with murder. By the mid-90s, following two gold albums and six top 10 singles, High Five had hopes for a bright future. But their new label, Giant Records, soon focused their attention on singer Tony Thompson, Alone.
They did not want to do a High Five album, but they wanted Tony so bad, they agreed to do a Tony Thompson album and a High Five album, with Tony's album coming out first.
It's not new news that a lead singer somehow or another wants to separate or go on his own.
So what happens to the group? They shelf us. You know what I'm saying?
We actually tried to pick up another member when Tony started doing his solo project, because at that point we didn't want to wait, and every time we went to the record label, they was like, we gotta have Tony.
Giant never recorded an album by High Five. Just like that, their run was over.
We just kind of got to the point where, you know what, let's just leave here, go home, and we'll see where it goes from here.
But Tony Thompson now had a problem as well, one that his bandmates had helped him conceal from the record label.
We hid a lot of things, you know, from the outside people about, you know, it's because he had a problem that kind of progressed it, you know, to cocaine.
We all dibbled and dabbled in drugs, but because of the grace of God, we did not get caught up the way my man Tony got caught up.
You know, we kind of shadowed Tony. When he got out there by himself, I think that's when he started exposing himself to what was going on, unfortunately.
After Tony's album failed to crack the top 40, Giant Records cut their ties with him. He went on to sign a deal with Puffy Combs' Bad Boy Records, but drug issues derailed that project as well.
I know there was rehab and there was, you know, interventions, I mean, and all that. And I think by that point, you know, it was just, it was too far gone.
Then in 2005, Tony Thompson reemerged with an album branded as High Five and a group that included Terrence Murphy, along with three new members.
This was kind of his chance to provide for our home and to provide for his son and to provide for his family again and really make a huge comeback.
It definitely upset me, you know, because if these guys are so talented, then maybe you want to start something different. You know, don't use the name that we created.
No, you can't do our fans like that. And you can't put four new guys in there who have a completely different image than what we put out.
We had to shut that situation down. Legally.
So Treston, Marcus, and Russell got a court injunction to stop sales of the album for improper use of High Five's name.
When he was served with those papers, he was like, how can you do this to me? I've done all that I can for this group, you know what I mean? And then when I want to do it again, you don't want me to do it.
It tore him apart because singing is all that he knew. You know, singing was his life.
And it was like, where do I go from here? Is, I believe, what he was saying. What do I do?
What's up, man? All right.
But then, in 2007, Treston Irby, along with Marcus Sanders, reached out to Tony with plans of putting the original High Five back together.
This was when Tony was ready to do the High Five again. The real High Five. He was like, yeah, man, me and Treston, we've been talking. So I was like, what? For real?
He still got life in store for us. Believe that. It's my man, the one and only.
Yeah, man, God's gonna make it work for us, man, and we're gonna put it back together, you know what I'm saying?
It's real. It's real right there.
And it's gonna go down.
It's gonna go down.
with no shackles, baby. We'll shake them all, baby.
Tony called me, and he said, I want to do an album. I said, well, Tony, you know, I heard a lot of rumors, this and that. No, I'm good. I'm good. Everything's straight. I'm straight. You know, I said, all right, well, let's do a high five.
We're going to see what time has in store for us, you know. But the first step was made, and it was a beautiful thing, man.
He had such a forgiving heart. It was like, let's move on. You know what I mean? We're not going to stay there. We're going to move forward.
But on June 1st, 2007, 2 weeks after this film footage was recorded, Tony Thompson's lifeless body was discovered near an air conditioning unit of an apartment complex in his hometown of Waco.
It was shocking to everybody, you know. You know, that's not the way I picture Tony going out, you know.
That is the hardest thing I've ever had to deal with in my life. Yeah.
The coroner's report stated that Tony Thompson died from inhaling a toxic amount of Freon. Traces of methadone were also in his system. He was 31 years old.
I can never say no to anything that you ask. And I really hope that you would do the same for me. Yeah.
He definitely would have left, I think, a bigger legacy, you know, had he been here with us longer.
When I be at places that I hear his music, you know, it ain't no sad thing. It make me feel good that he accomplished what he had, and he fulfills his dream.
I loved him so much, and he was my baby, and he's still in my heart, and he will be forever.
Tony Thompson's tragic death in 2007 seemed to spell the end for High Five, once and for all.
After Tone had passed away, you know, I went into a shell along with Marcus, because to us, that was it.
It's just like it died for me. I left music alone. It's like I didn't even like music no more.
But people were, when can we hear some High Five? You know, I want to see and hear High Five. And, you know, it kind of just made me start to believe that, you know, the fans still want to hear the music, and I guess even more so see how we would do it without Tony.
Yeah, I think me and Tony, we used to spray paint all the way out.
My man had a blonde woman, I remember that.
I'm sorry.
So in 2012, Tristan Irby, Marcus Sanders, and Shannon Gill reformed High Five with two new members, releasing a new single and heading back to the road.
We got to keep this legacy alive, man. We got to keep it going from the T. You know, we can't just give up.
Rest in peace, Tony Thompson.
Yes.
It's my business to make sure that the official High Five come back and finish what me and Tony is going to start up again.
New York City!
We're going to be singing forever, you know, like the Temptations, you know, we're going to grow old together. There will never be another Tony Thompson, but we all come together and here we are, High Five, we back, baby.
I do it in his memory, you know, and I want people to know that if it wasn't for him, you know, none of this would be possible. We keep the good music going and we keep his memory alive.
Oh, no, baby. Oh, yeah.